My name is Charles Frimpong, member of AfricaRice Mechanization Task Force, and I'm a fan. AMEFAN in Nigeria is an agricultural machine equipment fabricator association of Nigeria. I happen to be the national vice president. Yes, and I'm a fabricator with a company called HANIGHA. We are into fabrication of agriculture and agro-allied machines. We've actually been in business for some time now. We've done quite a number of equipments until we came also to AfricaRice, and with the help of SARD-SC, a lot of things have happened. One, we had the opportunity to be trained on how to fabricate the acid thresher, which in Nigeria is called ACTA. ACTA is Agricultural Transformation Agenda Thresher. This thresher has been doing very well. In fact, we used to say that the thresher on its own has made a name for itself in Nigeria. I can tell you that since the inception, for the past 3 years, we have produced over 500 different types of threshers. That include also the acid thresher and multi-crop threshers, plus other threshers and stuff like that. Yes, we also had the opportunity quite recently to understudy the fabrication and installation of giant parabola, which we now took to our workshop. We have started, and the mines are also coming high, except that we have to go on a drawing board to make some slight modification. But so far, so good. The clients are quite impressed, and they are happy with this equipment. We've done also with the weeders, and we got a sample of the weeder from AfricaRice, and we've tried to produce it locally. What we basically do, normally when we produce these threshers and all that, we do have a lot of offcuts. These are the scrap materials. But what we've started doing, instead of selling them as scraps, we cut them into sizes, we pattern them, and we produce these weeders with it. And it's very helpful, because so far we have sold more than 300 of these weeders to various states in Nigeria from this scrap. So it is also very helping. In fact, I have pictures and all these things to even show where the Honorable Minister of Agriculture, when he visited my company, had to even use these weeders. Then again, at the same length, the Minister for Agriculture presently in Nigeria also visited us, and he was so much impressed with this acid thresher. And he came out with a suggestion, because in some part of Nigeria, more especially the northeast, west areas, it used to be very sunny during the hot season. And he came out with this suggestion that if we could introduce something like a canopy, what we have also done, those equipment going to up north there, we used to put a canopy. And this is helping, more especially the operators. When they are operating under the canopy, there is no question of them feeling very weak, and it helped in their production rate. They are able to produce a lot, and people are quite happy with all that. You now see that this time around, when we sell treasure within this axis, and people continue to say, why can't you give us the one that has the canopy on it? This request is also coming in. And a lot of things are happening. Not only that, we got the training free. We've been getting jobs here and there, and it is our duty also to help train the younger ones, you understand. I can tell you, we got orders, quite a number of orders from state government, federal government of Nigeria, and even individuals. And I tell you, our capacity is, we can do more because of certain basic equipments we need to help to maximize our, to high up our production rate. That we are also looking into, and we are hoping for in the near future to get some equipment like the CNC and quite a number of machines that will help make our job faster so that we can do more machines. For instance, we have to use stainless materials, and stainless, they are very expensive, except, you know, they have to come in groups. And sometimes some of them want to own individually, and when they do not have the financial power to do that, then it becomes a problem. So in that case, that is where we want to see how we'll be able to make much smaller one that can also cater for those who cannot afford a big one. Yeah, but so far so good with the giant parabola, is doing very well. Also the acetration, we have looked into it because of demands coming, and you find out that the lower income farmers who cannot afford a bigger one, but they also want to have one. So for that reason, we have to go on a drawing board, and we have come out with one which we have codenamed Mini Actor, that is Mini Acetration, and that is also gender friendly, and the cost is much less. Yes, but you see, as human, every day people want these things, and they want at much reduced rates. Cost of equipment are going, components are going high every day. So some of the things we have started doing is also to go on the drawing board and see how best we can reduce some of the materials we use. But one thing, we will not compromise with the standard, the quality, and also the ruggedness of the equipment. All this we have factored it in, you understand? But we want to see how best we can sell as much as possible to a number of people who want to make use of these machines. Then again, other things we also do that most people are quite happy, you understand? You produce these things, you give it to this client. Some of them, they are able to use it and use it well. Some of them use and they have also problem. What do? You always have to have a link. You have to have what you call, we have a policy that monitor the performance history of all the equipment we produce. For that reason, we make call to call, and we tell them whenever they have any challenges, they should always get to us. And at all times, as soon as we receive such calls, we always send some of our staff to go help to make sure that they get back to work. Presently, at my workshop, I have on my payroll about 35 workers. But then again, what we also do, annually, we take between 30 and 40 students from most tertiary institutions who come as ITF to come and understudy, and it is very helpful. You find that people come to beg so they can get a chance to work with us. The opportunity is that because we have work at all times doing, so when they come, they have the opportunity to practically do some of these things. They don't just come and read them on books. They come, they have to get themselves involved. And first, when they have the opportunity, they are able to learn and learn better. So some of the reports we get is that those who had opportunity to come and understudy from my company, HANIGHA Nigeria Limited, as soon as they go back, they always excel. So yeah, it is good. We continue to train. We are also working with, in collaboration with some state governments, to bring in youth so they can come and understudy. Because if we have too many people doing these things, you'll now see with the others coming, we'll be able to cover them. Because Nigeria is looking into the next 2 years to produce as much as over 3,000 threshers. We don't have the capacity, I must be honest with you. You know, we cannot do more. But when you have too many people who have opportunity to learn these things, you can always, you know, get some of them to produce them. And when it comes, you just have to get them involved. You can assort some of these components and, you know, you couple them and assemble them, and we'll go high. Yes, presently, just last week, I was in Ghana, Accra, and I had a meeting with a member of parliament who is in charge of rice, and all their complaint is that they do not have any treasure that is doing very well in Ghana. So as we talk, I have arranged for some component to be shipped down to Ghana. I'm not going to do a whole machine from Nigeria and send them to Ghana, but we are producing them components. Then we take them there. I have to send my men to go, but I've also make arrangement with local artisans who I have to bring them on board to help during the assembly. I believe they also learn from there, because Ghana has about 275 constituencies, and all the constituencies want this project to go into their side. So I know it's going to be quite a big job. While the government is thinking of its own, constituency by constituency are also looking for this opportunity. So I know that even if we are asked to do them, we can't. We have to get the Ghanaians involved. We have also I visited the Nigeria Republic, and we've been talking. So I'm just waiting for the right time when we are called. We'll also go and see how best we can help to train some of the artisans.